Hello everyone, I welcome you all for the course on Digital System Design. We live in a society where we use lots of electronics around us. The applications of the electronics include consumer electronics, industrial electronics, or it could be the medical electronics, defense and aerospace, and many more. Electronics in any form, either it can be digital or it can be in analog, it is useful only when people start using it. Now, what is digital electronics and what is analog electronics? Digital electronic uses discrete quantities to represent the information, whereas analog electronics deals with the continuous signals. This is the analog representation, whereas this is the digital representation of the signal. Now, moving further, digital design is nothing but it is the combination of, or it is built using the logic gates, which is called as the digital circuit, and it will be built for some of the functionality. In this course, I will be dealing with module 1. Module 1 is about the principles of combinational logic. Combinational logic is nothing but, as the name itself indicates, it combines the logic gates to form the digital circuit. Next, we have the canonical forms. Canonical forms gives the representation of the expression, or you can say it as it is about the representation, or it is one form of representing the switching expression. Next, we have the generation of the switching equations from the truth table. The equations generated from the truth table are not in the simplified form. So if they are not simplified, the hardware required for that is more. So to reduce the hardware, we need to simplify the expression. So for the simplification of the expression, we use the Carnot map. Here we study the Carnot map as well as Quinn-McCluskey techniques. Carnot map is the graphical representation, where Quinn-McCluskey technique is used for the computer solution. Carnot map we use for 3, 4, 5 variables, whereas for Quinn-McCluskey we study for 3 and 4 variables. And the textbook you need to refer is Digital Logic Application and Design, Thomson Learning 2001 by John M. Yarbrough. Let us start with the introduction. So first we will study what are the different gates and the truth table of the gates. Digital system is built using basic building blocks called the logic gates. The various logic gates are, as already you have studied, they are AND gate, OR gate, NOT gate, NAND gate, NOR gate, XOR gate, and XNOR gate. And they operate on the binary logic 0 and 1. AND gate. See, let us see what is AND gate. This is the symbol of the basic AND gate. See, this is the symbol of the basic AND gate, where we have two inputs A and B, and output is AB. Here, an AND is represented by the operator dot. And the expression is read as A and B. So this has to be read as A and B. If you see the truth table, A and B are the inputs and the output is represented by A and B. So for any, if any one of the input is 1, or you can say it as if any one of the input is 0 for the AND gate, the output is 0. If all the inputs are 1s, then only the output is 1. See, for 0, 0, it is 0, for 0, 1, it is 0, for 1, 0, it is 0, and for 1, 1, it is 1. So here both the inputs are 1, then only the output is 1. Next, going to the next gate, that is the OR gate. Now, what is OR gate? OR is represented by the operator plus, and remember, the expression is read as A or B. The symbol for the OR gate is like this. So we have A and B as the inputs and the output is read as A or B. The truth table of the OR gate describes that if any one of the input is 1, then the output is 1. If all the inputs are zeros, then only the output is zero. See here, in this case, this is 1, the output is 1. So for this case, we have 1, 0, the output is 1. And here, both the inputs are 1, then also the output is 1. So the OR gate is nothing but if any one of the input is 1, then the output is 1. The output is 0 when all the inputs are zeros. NOT gate. NOT gate is also called as the inverter. A NOT is represented by the operator bar symbol, that is bar like this, or an apostrophe. So this is the symbol. The NOT operation inverts the variable. See, this is the truth tape. This is the symbol of the NOT gate, or it is also called as the inverter. If A is the input, A bar is the output. Now if you see the truth table, if 0 is the input, then the output is 1. For the input 1, the output is 0. The NOT gate inverts the input. For 0, it gives the output as 1. For 1, it gives the output as 0. Next, NAND gate. A NAND is a function derived from NOT and AND. See, NAND gate is a combination of AND gate and the NOT gate. See here, we have AND gate and then we have the NOT gate. So these two are the inputs and this is the output Y. This is the output Y. And if you see the symbol, this is the AND gate and the bubble at the output represent the inverting operation, or it represents the NOT gate. So therefore we say it as NAND gate as a combination of AND gate and the inverter. And see the truth table. For 0-0 combination, what is the output of the AND gate? The output of the AND gate is 0. Since NAND gate is inverted, so therefore the output of the NAND gate will be 1. So for 0-1 combination, the output of the AND gate is 0. For NAND, it is 1. So we can say that the AND output is inverted to get the final NAND output. So for 0-0, it is 1, 0-1, 1, 1-0-1, and for 1-1, if you consider the AND gate, it is 1, whereas for the NAND, it is 0. Similarly, for the NOR gate. NOR gate is a combination of OR operation and the NOT operation. So here we have OR gate and then we have inverter, or you can say it as it is a NOT gate. And two inputs are A and B. And this is the symbol of the NOR gate. We have the OR gate and then the bubble at the output represents inverting operation. So again it is same as the, like it as similar to the NAND gate. Here we, the OR input or output is inverted to get the final NOR output. So for 0-0, if you consider only the OR gate, the output is 0. But for the NOR, it is 1. For 0-1, if you consider only the OR output, it is 1. But for the NOR, it is 0. So similarly, for 1-0, the NOR output is 0. And for 1-1, the OR output is 1, but whereas the NOR output is 0. Next, XOR gate. An exclusive OR function produces a true output when an odd number of input variables are true. An input XOR function is written as Y is equal to A exclusive B. See, this is the symbol of the XOR gate. A and B are the inputs. The output is A exclusive B. See here, an exclusive OR function produces a true output when an odd number of input variables are true. See, for these two cases, the output is 1, whereas for these two cases, the output is 0. XNOR gate. XNOR gate produces true output when an even number of input variables are true. An XOR is the inverse of XOR, that is XOR combined with a NOT function. See here, this is a XOR and the bubble at the output indicates, or the at the output of the symbol indicates it is a NOT gate, or you can say it as it is the inverted operation. So XOR inverted will give you the XNOR operation. So therefore it is just the opposite of XOR. XNOR gate produces a true output when an even number of input variables are true. See here, true output. So here even number of input variables are true, therefore XNOR output is 1. Even for the first case, XNOR output is 1. For these two cases, the XNOR output is 0. These are the various gates in the digital design. Now coming to this definition of the combinational logic. Now what is a combinational logic? Combinational logic is a technique that combines the basic gates into circuits to perform the desired function. This is a combinational logic of function f. So this f, function f, is supplied with the inputs from x0 to xn. It operates on these inputs and gives the outputs y0 to ym. Let us consider one general logic design sequence. So in the general logic design sequence, for that matter, for anything, for any design, always it has to start with a problem statement. For the digital design, once the problem statement is defined, a truth table is constructed. Truth table gives the input-output relationship. Or you can say it as when, for example, if you want to design the half adder circuit. Or you can say it as you want to add two bits, 0 and 1. So I want to add two bits, 0 and 1. So what are the different combinations for this 0 and 1? So when I add these two, I get two outputs. One is sum output and another one is the carry output. One is sum output and another is the carry output. So when you add, so let me explain. So when you add 0 and 1, what is the sum? Sum is 1. What about the carry? Carry is 0. So similarly for 1, 0, you have the sum as 1 and carry as 0. For 1, 1, the sum will be 0 and the carry is 1. For 0, 0, both sum and carries are, sum and carry are zeros. So this is the truth table. Now after the truth table construction, switching equations are written for the output, for the output column. Then the equations are simplified. This we will be studying. The equations, the algorithms we are studying is the K-map as well as the Quinn-McCluskey. So using those, the equations are simplified for our syllabus, and then the logic diagram is drawn and the logic is implemented onto the hardware. So here either CMOS can be used, TTL can be used, or ECL can be used. So through any type of the technology, the logic circuit is built onto the hardware. This is a general design sequence for the design and the implementation of the circuit. For deriving of the switching equations, we need some of the basic definitions. So let us see the basic definitions. The first definition is the literal. Literal, a literal is a Boolean variable or its complement. So suppose x is a literal, or x bar can be the literal. So literal is one Boolean variable. Either it could be x or it could be y, or it could be the complement of any of those variables. Next is the product term. A product term is a literal or the logical product of the multiple literals. So product term, either it can be x or it can be xy if x and y are the variables, or it can be x bar, y bar, z if x, y and z are the variables. Similarly, sum term is a literal or the logical or of multiple literals. So sum term can be either x, or it could be x plus y, or it could be, so you have to say it as it is or. So plus is nothing but it is the logical or. So you have to say it as x or y, or it could be x bar, or y bar or z bar. Those are the sum terms. Next is sum of products. A sum of products is the logical OR of the multiple product terms. See, as the name itself indicates, sum of products. There are many products. So when you sum those, then it forms the sum of product expression. So similarly, product of sums. A product of sums is the logical AND of multiple OR terms. There are multiple OR terms. So multiple OR terms could be x or y bar or x bar or y bar or z. So these are the different sum terms. When you take the product of that, then it is called as the product of sums. Next definition is the min term. A min term is a special case product term. A min term is a product term that contains all the input variables that make up the Boolean expression. Means that if the Boolean expression contains A, B, C, D, then the min term should contain all the variables either in its original form or in its complement form. That is what is known as the min term. So similarly, max term is a special case sum term. A max term is a sum term that contains all the input variables that make up the Boolean expression. Min term is a product term, or you can say it as AND term, whereas max term is the OR term. Next definition is canonical sum of products. A canonical sum of products is a complete set of min terms that defines when an output variable is logical 1. This you have to remember. A canonical sum of product is a complete set of min terms that defines when an output variable is logical 1. Canonical product of sums is a complete set of max terms that defines when an output is logical 0. Canonical sum of product is with respect to the output variable logical 1. Canonical product of sums is with respect to the output variable at logical 0. These are the various definitions of the digital logic. You can say it's digital electronics. Thank you.